model we use to describe the short-run determinants of GDP is known as the ADAS model, which comes from the Keynesian approach of macroeconomics, which highlights the role of aggregate demand in determining the equilibrium. In this model, we assume that we can draw aggregate supply in a graph represented by an axis system where we have GDP and the price level. And we assume that aggregate supply can be drawn as a flat line, increasing and becoming steeper as we reach the level of GDP corresponding to the maximum level of GDP in the short run. The assumption here is that prices are stable when we are far away from the maximum level of GDP that can be obtained in the short run. But prices will tend to increase when we are closer to the full employment level of GDP. What determines the actual current level of GDP is the position of aggregate demand. Aggregate demand is represented by a downward sloping line intersecting aggregate supply. And equilibrium, that is the level of GDP that we actually observed, is given by the intersection of these two lines. At equilibrium, what we assume is that demand is fully satisfied and supply is also satisfied. And in equilibrium, consumers get what they want and firms produce without having too many or too little inventories. In this sense, the intersection is an equilibrium as it satisfied aggregate supply and aggregate demand. The equilibrium can be a good one, very close to full employment of all factors of production, or a bad one. We can have an equilibrium with a low level of aggregate demand that creates a GDP level which is very far away from full employment. In this type of equilibrium, what we observe is that the level of demand is low, firms react by producing less than in full employment, and this is an equilibrium where we will observe not full use of available factors. We can have equilibrium where demand is very high and we have a situation where prices are pushed upward by this very, very high level of demand. So what determines equilibrium in this situation is the behavior of demand driven by the behavior of consumers and people that purchased based on the income they received. The determinant of an intermediate level of equilibrium, or a high level of equilibrium, or a low level of equilibrium, bad because of unemployment, is essentially, therefore, the position of aggregate demand. Aggregate demand depends on individual choices of consumers, of firms, of the public administration, deciding how much to buy according to their income, according to their future production plans, or according to their budget constraint. In aggregate demand, consumption represents private consumption by households demanding goods and services to satisfy their needs. Instead, investments are made essentially by firms with the aim of expanding their production capital. Public expenditures are done by the government to provide public goods to the public, while net exports are given by the difference between goods exported and goods imported by the country from the rest of the world. In general, we assume that consumption will increase when available income increases, that is, when income net of taxes and including transfers increases. Firms' investment instead is assumed to depend negatively from the market interest rate, because when interest rates are lower, it's cheaper to borrow to pay for the equipment that firms need. Public expenditures depend to a large extent on government choices, while net exports depend on the level of international economic activity and on the exchange rate activating transactions across countries. Changes in one of these components will shift the aggregate demand curve to the right if there is an increase in consumption, investment, public expenditure, or net exports, and to the left in case there is a reduction of one of these components. Therefore, shifts in the aggregate demand curve are determined by changes in the variables affecting all these components. In this respect, economic policies might have an important role by shifting one of these components of aggregate demand.